Thank you, we glorify your name, we adore you, because from everlasting to everlasting, only you alone are God. There's no one like you, there's no one besides you, there's no one that can be compared with you. Thank you for this beautiful, oh God, and bright day. Thank you, my God and my Father, for your grace and your mercies. Father, we are asking this morning that you have your way. Holy Spirit, take absolute authority and control. Let the name of Jesus be lifted up, that he will draw souls to the kingdom. Father, it's all of you and none of me, O God. Let Jesus be exalted, O Lord, my God. Let souls be won to the kingdom. Circumcise the heart of your people. Let the seed of your word that will fall this morning fall on fertile grounds, O Lord, my God, that the seed shall germinate and bear fruit, and fruit that will last. Blessed be your name, O King of glory. Holy Spirit, take the stage and have your way. At the end of it all, I shall be very, very careful to return all the glory to you, O Lord. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen. You're welcome once again on this platform as we turn our Bibles quickly to 1 Samuel chapter 30, verse 1 to 25. 1 Samuel chapter 30, 1 to 25. David and his men reached Ziklag on the third day. Now the Amalekites had raided the Negev and Ziklag. They had attacked Ziklag and burned it, and had taken captive the men, the women, and all that were in it, both young and old. They killed none of them, but carried them off as they went on their way. When David and his men came to Ziklag, they found it destroyed by fire, and their wives and sons and daughters taken captive. So David and his men wept aloud until they had no strength left to weep. David's two wives had been captured, Ahinoam of Jezreel and Abigail, the widow of Nabal of Carmel. David was greatly distressed because the men were talking of stoning him. Each one was bitter in spirit because of his sons and daughters. But David found strength in the Lord his God. Then David said to Abiathar the priest, the son of Ahimelech, "Bring me the ephod." Abiathar brought it to him, and David inquired of the Lord, "Shall I pursue this raiding party? Will I overtake them?" "Pursue them," he answered. "You will certainly overtake them and succeed in the rescue." David and the 600 men with him went to the Bezor Ravine, where some stayed behind, for 200 men were too exhausted to cross the ravine. But David and 400 men continued the pursuit. They found an Egyptian in a field and brought him to David. They gave him water to drink and food to eat, part of a cake of pressed figs and two cakes of raisin. He ate and was revived, for he had not eaten any food or drunk any water for 3 days and three nights. David asked him, "To whom do you belong, and where do you come from?" He said, "I am an Egyptian, the slave of an Amalekite. My master abandoned me when I became ill 3 days ago. We raided the Negev of the Keratites and the territory belonging to Judah, and the Negev of Caleb, and we burned Ziklag." David asked him, "Can you lead me down to this raiding party?" He answered, "Swear to me before God that you will not kill me or hand me over to my master, and I will take you down to them." He led David down, and there they were, scattered over the countryside, eating, drinking, and reveling because of the great amount of plunder they had taken from the land of the Philistine and from Judah. David fought them from dusk until the evening of the next day, and none of them got away except 400 men who rode off on camel and fled. David recovered everything the Amalekites had taken, including his two wives. Nothing was missing, young or old, boy or girl, plunder of or anything else they had taken. David brought everything back. He took all the flocks and herds, and his men drove them ahead of the other livestock, saying, "This is David's plunder." Then David came to the 200 men who had been too exhausted to follow him and who were left behind at the Bezor Raven. They came out to meet David and the people with him. As David and his men approached, he greeted them. But all the evil men and troublemakers among David's followers said, "Because they did not go out with us, we will not share with them the plunder we recovered. However, each man may take his wife and children and go." David replied, No, my brothers, you must not do that with what God has given us. He has protected us and handed over to us the forces that came against us. Who will listen to what you say? The share of the man who stayed with the supplies is the same as to him who went down to the battle. All will share alike. David made this a statute, an ordinance for Israel from that day to this. Praise the Lord. We have read a very long passage. We thank God for this very passage. Our topic this morning says, encourage yourself in the Lord. Encourage yourself in the Lord. The word encourage means to inspire with courage, spirit, or hope. Means to hearten. Number two, it means to attempt, to persuade. That is to urge. It also means, number three, to spur on. That's to stimulate. So our topic this morning is telling us that we need to urge ourselves, we need to stimulate ourselves, we need to inspire ourselves with courage in the Lord. Encourage yourself in the Lord. Everyone needs encouragement, both big and small, rich and poor. Everybody, at one point or the other in your life, you need an encouragement. I also want to say that encouragement infuses hope and strength. When life gets tough, encouragement infuses hope and strength. When life gets tough, I read a book some years ago, I think it was by Paul Yonggi Cho. He said, "Tough times never last, but tough people do." How will tough people last? Tough people will last when they find strength and encouragement in the Lord their God. Hallelujah. Amen. So we see that encouragement infuses hope and strength when life gets tough. So when life gets tough, you will find strength in the Lord your God. Hallelujah. But as you grow and mature in your walk with God, you will realize that sometimes there is no one available to encourage you, because everyone around seems to be dealing with their own crisis. So as we mature in our Christian life, as we get along in our Christian life, you come to a point where you look at your left, at your right, there's nobody to encourage you. It's not because people will not want to encourage you, but it's because people are passing through their own crisis. People have their own challenges. And so you look around you to see whether somebody can encourage you, and you don't find anybody. That is the time to find strength in the Lord your God. Hallelujah. Amen. That time it looks like the world is so self-consumed that encouragement to others is scarce. Especially during this pandemic, when people are in lockdown, on lockdown, and everybody is inside the house, people need encouragement. And it seems as if this encouragement is scarce now. People are facing one challenge or the other. The person you are looking up to encourage you is also passing through one kind of hardship or crisis or the other. And so you see people that the pressure and busyness of life leave little or no room for anyone else. And with a lack of encouragement, people are becoming hopeless. Because of this lack of encouragement, people are becoming hopeless. They are turning to destructive behaviors, becoming addicts, and even contemplating suicide. Not even contemplating. Some have committed suicide because there was nobody to encourage. Because there was nobody to, you know, stimulate them, to inspire them. Some have even gone to the extent of committing suicide. We are all in need of someone in our lives to lean on. At one point or the other in your life, you just need someone to lean on, to find comfort in. Somebody who can share your burdens. You see, at times you're so burdened that you just feel you can see somebody to talk to. At that point in time, you need an encouragement. But unfortunately, someone may not always be there. Or even if they are around, they are dealing with their own problems to recognize that you need help. So people have their own challenges. At that point, you need somebody to lean on. At that point, you need somebody to encourage you. At that point, you need somebody to talk to. There may be people around you, but each and every one of them are, you know, being encapsulated by their own challenges and crises. And it's as if they are not even recognizing your own need. But thanks be to God that we have the Lord whom we can always derive our strength from. The God that does not sleep. The God that does not slumber. Our Heavenly Father is not occupied with anything that will make him not to hear you at any point in time. No matter the time you want to call upon him, be it at daytime, be it at midtime, be it in the bus, be it in the sea, be it in the air, whenever you want to call upon him, the Lord is always there to give you an attention. Praise God. Hallelujah. Let's turn our Bibles. Let's look at an example with the life of our Lord Jesus Christ in Mark chapter 14. In Mark chapter 14, let's read from verse 32 to 41. Mark chapter 14, verse 32 to 41. They went to a place called Gethsemane, and Jesus said to his disciples, "Sit here while I pray." He took Peter, James, and John along with him, and he began to be deeply distressed and troubled. "My soul is overwhelmed with sorrow to the point of death," he said to them. "Stay here and keep watch." Going a little further, he fell to the ground and prayed that if it be possible, he prayed that if possible, the hour might pass from him. "Abba, Father," he said, "everything is possible for you. Take this cup from me, yet not what I will, but what you will." Then he returned to the disciples and found them sleeping. "Simon," he said to Peter, "are you asleep? Could you not keep watch for 1 hour? Watch and pray so that you will not fall into temptation. The spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak." Once more he went away and prayed the same thing. When he came back, he again found them sleeping because their eyes were heavy. They did not know what to say to him. Returning the third time, he said to them, "Are you still sleeping and resting? Enough, the hour has come. Look, the Son of Man is betrayed into the hands of sinners. Rise, let us go. Here comes my betrayer." Let's also join it with verse 49 to 50. Verse 49 to 50. "Every day I was with you, teaching in the temple courts, and you did not arrest me, but the scriptures must be fulfilled." Then everyone deserted him and fled. Praise the Lord. This is an example with our Lord Jesus Christ. Jesus needed encouragement. At that point in time in his life, after he had the last supper with his disciples, when he told them that one of them would deny him, they all said, surely is it I? Surely is it I? Nobody, you know, accepted. Jesus told them that one of them will betray him, and one person will also deny him. And after the Lord's Supper, Jesus now took them to Gethsemane, where they had to, where he wanted them to pray with him. Because at that point, Jesus needed encouragement. Jesus needed to be strengthened in his inner man, because he knew that he cannot do anything by his own strength. And so he took his disciples to Gethsemane to go and pray with him. Mm-hmm. But can you imagine what happened? Instead of praying with him, they were sleeping. Can you imagine yourself? You have a burden, and you call your friends, your close friends, to come and pray with you. Instead of praying, they are there sleeping. At the point in time when Jesus needed them most to help him to intercede, they were all sleeping. Because Jesus knew that it is in the place of prayer that he will, number one, you can receive transfiguration of life and countenance. That was why he took his disciples to go and pray with him. He knew that there at the place of prayer, there will be transfiguration and of life and countenance. You remember the time Jesus went to the mountain, and at the mountain of transfiguration, there Moses and Elijah appeared with him. And there they discussed, and the Bible said that they were transfigured, and the countenance of the Lord changed. And so Jesus knew that it's at the place of prayer that there is transfiguration of life and countenance. Number two, he knew that it is at the place of prayer that you will receive the enhancement and enlargement of capacity. He knew that very well. Number three, he knew that you will receive impartation of honor and dignity in the place of prayer. In the place of prayer is where you receive honor and dignity. Number four, he knew that in the place of prayer, you can arrest uncertainties and fear of the future. At the place of prayer, you arrest all uncertainties and fear of the future. And number five, he also knew that you can arrest powerlessness to confront the future at the place of prayer. So Jesus knew all this, and that was why he asked his disciples to come and pray with him. But they went there and they slept. He even told them, if you cannot pray with me or pray for me, pray for yourself so that you will not fall into temptation. But still, they slept. May God help us in Jesus' name. Amen. May the Lord not find you sleeping. May you not be sleeping at the time you need to encourage yourself in the Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. So even though Jesus was surrounded by his disciples for years, but that night, he was arrested in his most desperate moment that he needed support and encouragement. They all bailed out on him. They deserted him and fled. At that night, Jesus needed his disciples most. That night, he needed their encouragement. When he was arrested, the Bible said that they all fled. They deserted Jesus and fled at the point when Jesus needed them most. Just like Jesus, we face moments like these when the ones we are looking up to for motivation are not available. At times, there are people you're looking up to motivate you, to inspire you, but they're not available. Perhaps, it is not that they don't want to be there, but as I mentioned earlier, they too are facing their trials and hardships. At times, it's not that they don't want to be there to encourage you, but because they are also facing their own trials and hardship, they're not available to encourage you. But how did Jesus get through these moments of abandonment and isolation? Let's look at how he got through this period of abandonment and isolation. I believe he encouraged himself. Jesus encouraged himself because he had only two options. Jesus had only two options. One, give up and lose the war over sin and death forever. He had an option to decide. I'm going to throw in the towel. I'm going to give up and lose the war for sin and death forever. The second option he had was to encourage himself and win the battle for all humanity. These were the two options that Jesus had. But thanks be to God that Jesus chose the second option. Because of his love for humanity was greater than himself. He chose to encourage himself and win the battle for all humanity. Hallelujah! Amen! The writer of Hebrews tells us that Jesus made it to the end. Despite all his hardships, he encouraged himself. And we also need to keep our eyes on him when we are facing or passing through challenges in our lives. As we keep our eyes on Jesus, he will also carry us through. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. So Jesus was encouraged by his Father. He received that encouragement when his physical friends deserted him. Even we know at the point when he was on the cross, he cried out to his Father, "Father, Father, why have you forsaken me?" God had to do that because of you and because of me, so that Jesus will pay the price for our salvation. But thank God that he did not end up on the cross. When he went to the grave, he did not end in the grave. On the third day, God the Father decided to resurrect his soul. He sent his Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, go and resurrect my soul. And there in the grave, we know that Jesus fought the battle. He collected the keys of death from Satan. He made a public spectacle of the devil. He triumphed over him. And on the third day, the Holy Spirit went forth. And Jesus Christ was resurrected from the dead. Hallelujah! The strife is over and the battle is won. Jesus triumphed over death. And so as you look unto him, you will also triumph. Hallelujah! Amen! So let's look at the life of David, where we read in our text in 1 Samuel. We saw that David had an unexpected tragedy. David had an unexpected tragedy. We remember that from the preceding chapters of 1 Samuel, David was running away from Saul because Saul was pursuing him to kill him. So in the bid of running away, he went to the Philistine country and Achish, their king, accepted him and gave him a place to stay. So one of those periods, the Philistines were to go to battle against the Israelites. And Achish invited David and his men to go with him. And so David and his 600 men followed Achish to go to battle to fight against the Israelites. But the commanders of the Philistines told Achish that David should not go with them. If not, when the battle is fierce, he will begin to fight against them in order to win favor from Saul. And so David and his men were sent back. By the time they came back to Ziklag, after having trekked for 3 days, they only came and found out that Ziklag has been burnt down. Their wives, their children, everything they had were taken away. The Bible said that they cried. They cried and they had no strength to cry again. And the men decided to stone David. They decided to stone David to death. At that point, you can imagine David. What is he going to do? With 600 men crying and about to stone him. Nobody was there again to encourage David. But the Bible said in that 1 Samuel chapter 30 verse 8b that David found strength in the Lord his God. David found strength in the Lord his God. That is where we derive this topic. Encourage yourself in the Lord. At that moment in your life when it's as if the situation looks hopeless, everything has turned against you, that is the time to find strength in the Lord your God. Hallelujah. So let's look at how can you encourage yourself in the Lord? How can you encourage yourself in the Lord? Hebrews chapter 12. Hebrews chapter 12. We'll still get back to the story of David, but let's handle how can you encourage yourself in the Lord. Hebrews chapter 12 verse 1 to 3. Therefore, since we are surrounded by such a great cloud of witnesses, let us throw off everything that hinders and the sin that so easily entangles, and let us run with perseverance the race marked out for us. Let us fix our eyes on Jesus, the author and perfecter of our faith, who for the joy set before him endured the cross, scorning his shame, and sat at the right hand of the throne of God. Consider him who endured such opposition from sinful men, so that you will not grow weary and lose heart. Praise the Lord. The Bible made us to know in this place. Number one, for us to encourage ourselves in the Lord, we must throw off every hindrances. Everything that hinders. Everything that will be a barrier. Everything that will stop you from receiving this encouragement from the Lord, you must throw it off. The Bible said, throw off everything that hinders. Number two, you need to study the word of God. Believe the word of God and persevere. You see, when you know the word of God, when you have hidden this word in your heart, when that moment, that challenging time will come, the word of God in you will pop up. And you will use that word to encourage yourself. The Bible says here, persevere. You need to persevere. You need to refuse to give up. No matter the challenge, no matter the hardship, refuse to give up. Keep on trying. Continue. Even when it is difficult, keep on holding on. Keep on pressing on. Never you throw in the towel. Never you accept defeat. Keep on believing the word of God. Persevere. The Bible says that they that persevere till the end shall be saved. So for you to encourage yourself in the Lord, you need to throw off everything that hinders. You need to believe the word of God. You need to have faith in the word of God. You need to persevere in the Lord. Number three, you have to fix your eyes on Jesus, the author and finisher of your faith. Fix your eyes on Jesus Christ. Remain focused. Don't allow anything to distract you. When you fix your eyes on Jesus, you will receive encouragement. You will receive divine strength to continue to push. Hallelujah. You receive divine encouragement to continue to press on. Keep on holding on. Hallelujah. Number four, be ready to put up with anything along the way. You must be ready to put up with anything along the way. The cross, the shame, name it. The Bible said that Jesus Christ himself scorned the shame, and he considered, he even endured opposition from sinful men. Jesus scorned the shame. So no matter what may come your way, be ready to endure the cross. Be ready to put up with anything along the way. Be it the cross, be it shame, be it derision, be it insults. Be ready to put up with them because you know where you are going. The Bible said that Jesus Christ himself scorned the shame of the cross, and he endured opposition, even from sinful men. And so as we focus on him, we too will triumph. Number five, never lose sight of where you are going. This is what will encourage you. When you don't lose sight of where you're going, I'm running a race to meet my Redeemer. Brethren, we are running a race to meet Jesus. We need to remain focused. Never lose sight of where you are going. We are going to heaven. Heaven is a beautiful place. So when you remain focused, when you don't lose sight of where you're going, then you'll be able to endure. You'll be able to receive encouragement from the Lord. Never you lose sight. There is nothing the Bible, Paul told us in the scriptures, that whatever we are passing through here on earth, they are temporary. They are momentary. Hallelujah. Whatever challenge you're going through, the Bible said they are momentary. They are temporary. You will not use it to compare with the beauty of heaven. You will not use it to compare with the glory of heaven. You will not use it to compare with the warm embrace that our Lord Jesus will give to you. The Bible told us in Revelation that with his handkerchief, he will wipe away every tears from your eyes. God will wipe away every tear. No matter how much you cried on earth, when you get to heaven, your tears will be wiped away. You won't remember them anymore. So never you lose sight of where you are going. Number six, what will encourage you even in the Lord? What will help you to encourage yourself in the Lord? Number six, keep your eyes on the prize. There is a race to be run. There is a victory to be won. There is a prize to win. There is a prize to win. And that prize is the crown of life. God will give you the crown of life when you endure till the end. He will give you the crown of life when you persevere till the very end. Remember, the crown of life awaits you. And so no matter the hardship, no matter whatever crisis you're going through here on earth, sisters and brothers, keep on holding on. Encourage yourself in the Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Let's look at the benefits. Benefits of encouraging yourself in the Lord. Number one, encouraging yourself in the Lord provides strength. When you encourage yourself in the Lord, it provides strength. Hallelujah. It provides you with strength. The Bible made us to know in that passage we read from 1 Samuel chapter 30 from verse 3 to 6. We saw that these men, when they came back to Ziklag and saw that everything, their wives, their children, all that they had in life has been taken away from them. Can you imagine these men? These men that gave up everything in the past to be dedicated and loyal to David, living on the run with this anointed king, hoping that one day they will be rewarded for their loyalty. Imagine the pain, the regret, the anger, and the hatred they must have felt in that moment. Imagine the loud cry of 600 men in that moment, crying on that tragic day. All their strength were sapped. They had no strength. The Bible said that they wept and came to the point that they had no strength again to cry. And there was nobody to encourage them. So the only alternative they had was to look for, deal with this person that has caused them this pain and ache. And so they passed the blame to David. They passed the blame to David. They decided to stone him. Looking at the situation and others for help will only bring further disaster, which will only weaken you. David knew that turning to this man, he cannot even turn to this man that wanted to stone him. And so what will he do? All the men were against him. What will he do? The Bible said, David found strength in the Lord his God. David found strength in the Lord his God. So, but like David, we can lift our eyes from the tragedy to the Lord our God, and he will infuse strength in your mind, emotions, and will. Hallelujah. Amen. When a man has no strength, if he leans on God, he becomes powerful. When a man has no strength, and that man decides to lean on God, that man or woman will be powerful. Hallelujah. So encourage yourself in the Lord. Encouraging yourself in the Lord will provide you with strength. David encouraged himself in the Lord, and he had strength. He became powerful. Praise the Lord. Number two, benefit. Encouraging yourself in the Lord will bring sensitivity and clarity to the voice of God. When you encourage yourself in the Lord, it will bring sensitivity and clarity to the voice of the Lord. We see that in 1 Samuel chapter 30 from verse 7. When David received strength from the Lord, the next thing he did was to ask Abiathar to bring the ephod. He inquired from the Lord. David inquired from the Lord. So after David encouraged himself in the Lord, he was strengthened. The strength that came from the shift of perspective positioned him to drown out the negatives. He drowned out the negatives and to hear with clarity the instructions for the next move. So when David received divine strength from the Lord, he could now became sensitive, and then he had clarity to the voice of God. Abiathar, bring a foil. Let's inquire from the Lord. What would the Lord want us to do at such a time as this? Sometimes in life, crying and wailing over situations that seem hopeless, takes us further down a rabbit hole with no end. When you keep dwelling, staying longer than expected, mourning, when you stay more than expected, crying and wailing over situations, it's like you're digging through a rabbit hole that has no end. It is imperative as a believer to know that with God, there is always hope, even when we can't see it. With God, there is always hope. No matter how hopeless that situation looks, no matter how hopeless that situation seems, I want you to know that in God, every hopeless situation, there is hope in it. The word of God can heal and give direction when no one else has the answer. When no one else has the answer. When no one else has a word to encourage you, the word of God can bring healing and give direction. So David asked God what to do, and God told him. He received a clear answer from the Lord. God told him, pursue, overtake, and recover all. Hallelujah! He received a direct instruction. Pursue, overtake, and recover all. I don't know what you're facing today. God is waiting for you to ask for his help. The Bible says we do not receive because we do not ask. But as you ask the Lord, just like David did, God will give you help. God will give you solution. God will give you direction in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Faith does not eliminate questions, but faith knows where to take the question to. That you have faith does not mean you can't ask questions. That you have faith means that you know where to take your questions to, the right place. David knew the right place. He's the Lord. What do I do next? And God told him, pursue, overtake, and recover all. Hallelujah. Amen. Number three benefit of encouraging yourself in the Lord is that you receive mental strength. You receive mental strength when you encourage yourself in the Lord. It positioned David to become sensitive to God's voice for direction and to move forward. God was very clear in his answer to David. God gave him a clear answer. Pursue, overtake, and recover all. I am amazed by the precise and distinct answer David received from God, all because he didn't wallow in self-pity and depend on others to bring him out of his hopeless situation. Because he depended on God to bring him out of his hopeless situation, he received precise and distinct answer from the Lord. Hallelujah. With this direct word from God on what David should do, he went to his men and encouraged them with the word of God. He encouraged these men that wanted to stone him. Because he now has received the word from the Lord, he could boldly go to them and tell them, this is what God said. I have a message from the Lord. God has given us the strategy of what to do. And immediately he told those men, the Bible said that those men that wanted to stone David, they all got up and agreed on the, and they agreed. They ventured to follow the word of God to pursue, to overtake, and to recover all. So when David went and intimated them about the word God has given to him, they all followed David. Praise the Lord. And we know the story very well. Another number four benefit is that when you encourage yourself in the Lord, you will receive physical strength to deal with the enemies. David received physical strength to pursue his enemies. Out of the 600 men, 400 of them were infused with physical strength to go to battle all the way. They went. 600 of them, they came. 200 were not strong enough. But 400 were infused with strength. We see that in 1 Samuel where we read chapter 30, verse 9 to 10. 400 of them received strength. And the Bible said that they followed, pursued their enemy. God will again bring others around you. When you encourage, will bring others around you. With the same words, encouragement you have received from the Lord, you will also use it to encourage them. Praise the Lord. And so they receive physical strength from the Lord to pursue their enemies. Number five, favor to know the enemy's plan and strategy for recovery. When you encourage yourself in the Lord your God, you will receive favor to know the enemy's plan and strategy for recovery. We see that in 1 Samuel 30, verse 11 to 16. They received the strategy. God will cause people and favor to follow you when you hear and obey his word in your times of distress. When you hear the word of God and obey it in your time of distress, God will cause men to come to favor you. Hallelujah. God will also give you strategies on how to handle the situation. Always seek for the Lord's strategy, God's direction in the midst of those situations. God will always grant you favor. You know what happened? How God now brought a slave, an Egyptian slave, that the master left because he was ill. God now used that slave to give them direction where their enemies were. Number six benefit, recovery and restoration of all. Recovery and restoration of all. When you encourage yourself in the Lord, you will receive recovery and restoration of all. David and his men had so much strength. They fought from twilight to the evening of the next day. They recovered all. The Bible said they recovered all. Nothing was missing. Nothing was missing. I believe, God, that as you encourage yourself in the Lord, even in this season of lockdown, you will recover all. None shall be missing in your family. None shall be missing in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. They recovered all. When you trust God and his word, you will not fail. Because God will keep his promises to you. All the promises that God has made unto you, he will keep them. Only keep on holding on. Number seven benefit, compassion for others. Compassion for others. We saw that in that first Samuel chapter 30 from verse 11. We see that Egyptian slave. Because David has received strength in the Lord his God, he had compassion on that slave. They brought the slave to him. They gave the slave food and water. He had compassion. They didn't say, let's kill him and go on our way. We are seeking, pursuing our enemies. This one will not be a hindrance. Let's just kill him off and go away. No. Because he has received strength from the Lord, he had compassion on that slave boy. And it was that slave boy that gave them direction where their enemy was. David also, after they had conquered their enemies and recovered all, when they were coming back, the other 200 men came to welcome them. The Bible said that some men who were troublemakers in their midst said that these men will only take their wives and children. They will not share in the plunder. But because David has received strength from the Lord his God, he had compassion. He told them, no, these men will also share with us in the plunder God has given to us. He had compassion on them. When you know what it's like to lose everything and stand alone, and you allow God's word to penetrate your heart, you will be moved with compassion to help and share with others. Praise the Lord. The Bible said the God of all comfort, who comforts us in our affliction, so that with the same comfort we have received, we'll be able to comfort others. If you have passed through hardship, if you have passed through poverty, you have compassion to help the poor. So David has passed through it. He knew what it meant. He has received strength in the Lord his God. And so he had compassion on those men and said, we are going to share the plunder with them. Hallelujah. It is amazing the series of benefits that can flow from just one decision to encourage yourself in the Lord. Something supernatural happens when you look to God rather than this hopeless situation. And God himself changes everything when you encourage yourself in him. When you encourage yourself in the Lord, God will change your situation. He will turn your story around. Jesus will give you a song in the night. Hallelujah. Amen. With God, you're stronger than your struggles. Amen. Can I hear somebody shout hallelujah? With God, you are stronger than your struggles and more fierce than your fears. God provides comfort and strength to those who trust in him. If only you will trust in the Lord, he will provide comfort. He will provide encouragement. He will provide strength to you. Only put your trust in him. Put your trust in him. Trust him. No matter what. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. He will give you a song. Jesus will give you a song in the night. Jesus will give you a song in the night. When all that you have trusted have failed you, Jesus will give you a song. Jesus will turn your story around, all to his own glory. Hallelujah. So be encouraged. Keep standing. And know that everything is going to be all right. In Jesus' name, everything is going to be all right. I don't know what you're passing through, but I have this good news for you. As you encourage yourself in the Lord, everything will be all right. Everything will be all right in your life. In the name of my Lord Jesus Christ, I don't know the distress you're going through. I don't know the hardship. I don't know the crisis. But I know that as you encourage yourself in the Lord, God will turn your story around. Praise the Lord. Remember that you are loved. God loves you. Even if no other person loves you, God loves you. Even in your weaknesses, God loves you. And never forget that there is always hope. There is always hope. Even in the midst of hopeless situations, there is always hope. Jesus will give you a hope. Jesus will give you a song. He will give you strength. Are you weak? Are you heavy laden? Come to Jesus. Lay your burdens at his feet. He will give you peace. He will give you joy. He will encourage you. In him you will find strength. Jesus will turn your story around. Oh, if only you will encourage yourself in the Lord. Don't worry.
Even if every other person has turned their backs on you, don't worry. Even if you can't find any encouragement from men, I want you to find encouragement in the Lord. When God comes to encourage you, when God strengthens you, when God fulfills His promises in your life, you will have every reason to return the glory to Him. Encourage yourself in the Lord your God. Shall we pray? Leba mama sandere bo shakata rababa. Thank you, my God and my Father. I worship you. I glorify your name, O God, for there's no one like you. There's no one besides you. There's no one that can be compared with you. Thank you, Ancient of Days. Thank you, Bright and the Morning Star. Thank you, the lily of the valley. Thank you, thou who sits enthroned on high. Thank you for your word and your promises that are all yea and amen. I want you to magnify the name of the Lord this morning. I want you to thank the Lord for this encouraging message this morning. You will find strength in the Lord your God. Keep on holding on, my brother and my sister. Keep on holding on, my friend. Don't throw in the towel. Don't be despondent. Don't be depressed. The Lord is there. Find strength in the Lord your God. My brothers and my sisters, find strength in the Lord your God. When it's as if everything has turned against you, when it's as if there is no one to encourage, find strength in the Lord your God. No matter the all one, no matter whatever tragedy you have seen your that has come upon you, I want you to find strength in the Lord your God. Find strength in the Lord your God. The Lord can never fail you. The Lord can never disappoint you. He can never fail. God is too faithful to fail you. Therefore, find strength in the Lord your God. Even at such a time as this, He is the one that will give you hope. Even in any seeming hopeless situation. Father, we thank you this morning. We worship and honor you. We glorify your name, Eternal Rock of Ages. For only you alone are worthy. Only you alone are faithful. Only you alone are dependable. Thank you, my God and my Father. There's nothing you cannot do. Thank you, O Lord, for this encouraging message this morning. We give you all the praise and glory. Thank you, O Lord, because in you, O God, we receive our divine strength. May your name forever be magnified and adored. In the name of Jesus this morning, I want us to pray for as many as are becoming discouraged, as many are passing through crisis in their life, as many as are passing through hardship, as many as are passing through terrible times, at such a time as this, even in this lockdown, as many as are passing through terrible times, I want us to lift them up before the throne room of grace. I want us to pray that God will bear them in His hands. I want us to pray that they will receive encouragement in the Lord our God. I want you to pray for such people, those that are depressed, those that are passing through terrible times, those that are passing through crisis in their life, those that are passing through crisis in their marriage, those that are passing crisis in their workplaces, those that are passing through crisis in their businesses, I want you to pray for them. Lift them up before the throne room of grace this morning. Pray that they will find strength in the Lord their God. Pray that God will help them. Pray that God will make a way for them where there seems to be no way. Father, Lord, we thank you this morning, oh God. As we lift up, O God, before you, Lord God Almighty, as many as are passing through crisis, O God, as many as are passing through hardship, O Lord, as many as are passing through terrible times in their lives, O Lord, crisis in marriage, crisis in business, O Lord, crisis, O King of Glory, divine in families, Lord, we are asking of you this morning, let there be divine intervention, O God, let there be divine intervention in such families, let there be divine intervention in such businesses, let there be divine intervention in such offices, O Lord, my God, divine intervention, my God and my Father. Let your children find strength in you, O God, at such a time as this, my God in heaven. Make a way for them where there seems to be no way, O God. Let every mountain be leveled, let every valley be filled, O God, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, Lord God Almighty, we are praying, O God, that these ones shall find strength in you, that they will find strength in you, my God and my Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. In Joshua chapter 1 verse 9, the Bible says, "Have I not commanded you? Be strong and courageous. Do not be terrified. Do not be discouraged. For the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go. I want you to claim this word of God. The Bible said, do not be afraid. Do not be discouraged. The Lord your God will be with you. I want you to pray this morning that the Lord our God will be with you, will be with your family. You don't need to be afraid. You don't need to be discouraged. God has promised us that he will be with us. They that are with us are greater in number than they that are against us. I want you to pray this morning. Oh Lord God Almighty, we are lifting up before you, oh Lord, as many, oh God, at the point of discouragement. There's the King of Glory that are fearful, oh Lord. We are praying this morning, Lord, encourage them, oh God. Take away every form of fear from them, my God and my Father. Cause them to realize, oh Lord, my God, that you are with them. And because you are with them, oh Lord, my God, nobody can be against them. In the name of my Lord Jesus Christ, blessed be your name, most excellent God. Be thou glorified and adored, oh Lord. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen. Jeremiah chapter 31. Jeremiah chapter 31. We are reading verse 17. Jeremiah 31 verse 17 says, so there is hope for your future, declares the Lord. Your children will return to their own land. I want you to appropriate it this morning. The Bible said there is hope for your future. Jeremiah 31:17. There is hope for your future. I want you to claim it this morning. Lord, I thank you, oh Lord, because there is hope for our future, oh Lord. There is hope for our future, King of Glory Divine. There is hope, Lord God Almighty. Are there people, oh God, who are passing through, oh God, a seemingly hopeless situation? Cause them to realize this morning, my God and my Father, that there is hope for their future, that there is hope for their future, in the name of my Lord Jesus Christ, amen. Isaiah chapter 40, Isaiah chapter 40, verse 31. Isaiah chapter 40, verse 31 says, but those who hope in the Lord will renew their strength, they will soar on wings like eagles, they will run and not grow weary, they will walk and not faint. I want you to pray this morning that God will renew your strength so that you will soar on wings like eagle, so that you will walk, you will not grow weary, you will run and you will not you will run and not grow weary, and you will walk and not faint. I want you to appropriate this passage this morning. Father, Lord God Almighty, we are praying, oh God, that our strength, oh God, shall be renewed in you, oh God. Let our strength be renewed in you, my God and my Father. Let the strength of your children be renewed in you, oh God, that your people will soar on wings like eagles, oh Lord. They will walk and not faint. They will run and not be weary, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, mighty and everlasting Father. Be thou glorified and adored. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Brethren, I want to tell us, for you to find encouragement in the Lord, you must be born again. You must be born again. If you are not yet born again, I cannot guarantee that you will find encouragement in him. Because the Bible says that the prayer of the unrighteous is an abomination to God. Therefore, this morning, I want to give you an opportunity to make peace with the Lord Jesus Christ. To ask Jesus to come into your life, to be your Lord, and to be your personal Savior. If you want to make these prayers this morning, I want you to say it after me, wherever you are, even if you have given your life to Christ before, but because of the things, the hardship, the crisis you found yourself in, you backslid and went back to the world. And today you want to be restored back to the Lord. You want to rededicate your life to Christ. Please join these ones and also say this prayer with me in the name of Jesus. Heavenly Father, I thank you for loving me. I thank you for sending your son, Jesus Christ, to die for my sins. I am a sinner. I cannot help myself. But thank you, Heavenly Father, for sending Jesus Christ to take my place and to die for me. This morning, I believe in my heart and I confess with my mouth that Jesus Christ is my Lord and my personal Savior. Heavenly Father, cancel my name from the book of death, transfer it to the book of life that is in heaven. Give me the power to live for you in the name of Jesus. Amen. God bless you as I pray with you. My God and my Father, I thank you, O Lord, my God, for these ones, Lord, that have made this commitment to the Lord Jesus. Father, they have made up their mind, O God, to surrender their life to Jesus Christ. Father, Lord, and those that are rededicating their lives unto you. Heavenly Father, I pray for them this morning, O God. I ask that you show them mercy. I ask that you look upon the blood of Jesus Christ and on the basis of the finished work on the cross of Calvary, Lord, forgive them, O God. Cleanse them from all sin and unrighteousness. Cancel their names from the book of death and sorrow. Transfer their names to the book of life that is in heaven. Give them the power to live a victorious Christian life, rooted and built up in Christ, in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, my God and my Father. Mm-hmm. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Father, we want to thank you for today, O God. We glorify your name for this encouraging message you have given to us, even at such a time as this over the nations, Lord, when, O God, many people are losing their faith and strength in you, O God, when the strength of many, O God, most people are going weary and weak, O God. Father, Lord, we thank you for encouraging us with your word this morning, O God, that we can find encouragement in the Lord our God. We thank you, O Lord our God. We want to pray for as many, O God, as have come to the point, O God, that they want to throw in the towel. They want to give up, O Lord. Father, Lord, we are praying for them, O God. We pray against every spirit of discouragement. We pray against every spirit of discouragement. We pray against every spirit of despondency. We pray against every spirit of depression. In the name of my Lord Jesus Christ, Father, we are praying, O God, that you encourage them. We speak, O God, encouragement, O God, unto such people, my God and my Father. Encourage them, O God, even at such a time as this, my God in heaven. Are there those, O God, who are passing through seemingly, O God, hopeless situation? Father, I pray this morning, O Lord, my God, that you give them hope, O God. Give them hope, O King of glory. For you told us, where we read in Jeremiah 31, verse 17, that there is hope, O God, for the hopeless. There is hope for the future of your people. Father, give them hope, O King of glory, no matter whatever hardship, no matter whatever crisis, O Lord, that they will be encouraged, O Lord, my God, to know that you will never leave them, you will never forsake them. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, holy and righteous Father, in every family where there is crisis at such a time as this, we proclaim the peace of God. We proclaim the peace of God. Give them peace, O Lord, that transcends all human understanding. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we give you thanks, we give you praise. Hallowed be your name, O Lord our God. Thank you, Lord, for as many as are sick. Release your healing anointing upon them. Let every yoke of infirmity be broken in their lives, O Lord. Let them be totally and completely made whole, my God and my Father. Lord, as many as have believing you for one thing or the other, no matter whatever may be the prayer request of your people, as long as it's in line with your will for their lives, O Lord, grant them speedy answer. Grant them speedy answer, O Lord, my God, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, mighty and everlasting Father. We continue to pray for the frontliners, O God, in this season. Continue to grant them divine shield and protection. Those in isolation units or those sick in the hospital, Papa, heal them, O God, totally and completely. God, those that are mourning, comfort and encourage and comfort them, O God, in the name of my Lord Jesus Christ. Father, we give you praise, we give you thanks. Hallowed be your name. We pray for missionaries at this point in time, as many as are missionaries, O God, who are at the point of giving up, O God, who are so depressed and discouraged, O God, in the mission field because of the problems they are passing through. Lord, I pray this moment, O Lord, encourage them, O God, encourage them, O God, favor them, O God, favor them, my God and my Father. Send aid unto them, my God and my Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Holy and righteous Father, we pray for the orphans, Lord. We pray for the widows, my God and my Father. We are praying this morning, O God, thou Father of the fatherless, thou husband of the widow, reach out to these ones, O Lord, my God. Be their Father, be their husband, O God. Encourage them, the vacuum, O God, that have been created, O God, by the demons of their father or husband. Father, fill that vacuum in their life, Lord. Do for them what their earthly father fathers, oh God, could not do for them. Do for them what their earthly husbands could not do for them. In the name of my Lord Jesus Christ, we give you thanks. We give you praise. Thank you, oh Lord God Almighty, because you promised us, oh Lord, that you will do for us exceedingly, abundantly, above all we can think of or imagine. Blessed be your name, eternal rock of ages. For in Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen and amen. God bless you for joining us again today. I believe you have been blessed by the message. Share the video, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and make sure that you remain connected. We'll be here again on Friday by the grace of God. God bless you. We love you. Jesus loves you best.